Hi everyone, welcome to 5 Minute Fridays. I'm Miranda.
I'm Dan.
And welcome. Let's go ahead and dive right in. So today we are streaming to YouTube at 1080p, 29.9 frames per second, and 6 megabytes per second. We're using our PTZ Optics 20X USB camera. The Audio Technica AT3031 is connected to the Behringer UMC 202HD. We're using a Papalux 720p. Our Acer laptop with vMix desktop capture sending NDI, our vMix mousepad, Freedom Edition. The X-Keys XKE 124 T-Bar with the video switcher key set, and vMix Pro is running on our MSI laptop. And we are using vMix Social on, well, trying to use that, but still drop us some comments.
Yep, we are still working on our vMix social skills. I guess we're socially challenged. We had a brief power outage here about 20 minutes ago that sent panic through the production team here.
Us.
But we're up and we're live. Hopefully we're live and you guys are seeing us.
Thanks.
Today, what we want to talk about is, you need to reset your slide to number one. USB HID. I was going to talk about software, but we can't really talk about the software without some background on USB and the way X keys communicate to a computer and control things.
Right.
So, off we go.
So, there are a few different ways. The first way is X keys software mode using MacWorld 3.1.
Or Controller Mate. If you plug a USB keyboard into your computer, it's going to send keyboard messages to a specific keyboard page in it's what we call USB HID, which stands for Human Interface Device. And so those messages just go to the keyboard page, your operating system picks them up and sends them to the active application, which, or the one on top, same thing, okay? And same thing with a mouse. You plug the mouse in, it goes to the mouse page, and it's sending mouse messages, and your OS is sending them to the active application. Now with the X keys, we come in on something called the HID consumer page, and we're sending our special data report. It's going in there. If there is nothing to look for it, then it does nothing. It sits there. So you need a piece of software with our DLL, and MacroWorks will pick up that message and then translate that through a script to either a keyboard or a mouse message. We can also do game controller, other stuff, but to simplify it, you know, it's basically keyboard or mouse going into that data stream, and it's going to the active application. So that's what we call software mode.
Right. And so then the next way is with hardware mode, and you can emulate keyboard and mouse stored macros. So the keyboard and mouse are same concept as in the software mode.
But this time, what we do is the X keys declares itself as a USB keyboard and mouse, and we have macros that are stored in the memory, and we're sending them to the keyboard and mouse page. The cool thing about this is that any application will see it because every application has been written to read keyboard or mouse. So even what we call reluctant applications that don't like input from other sources, they have to see it, and we can send stuff to them.
Right. And so the next way is X-Key software mode with custom application. So again, same concept with the keyboard and mouse.
Yeah, we also call this an integration. It's using our software development kit. And so a specific application like vMix or Wirecaster or Analog Way, they're looking at our data report, but instead of translating it into keyboard or mouse, it's going right into their application. They're reading the report. They see that this button went down, and so they do whatever they want to do with it.
Right.
And yeah, that's the integrated application. Like I said, vMix and Wirecast and Analog Way are three really good examples of that. There are a number of others out there. We have people who've integrated things, and that is the best way to control and manipulate X keys. With that integration, they can also talk back to the X keys. They can send, you know, messages to turn lights on or blink LEDs like vMix does, like Wirecast does, and I assume Analog Way, I'm not familiar with
their software.
So that is what I call USB HID 101 course. The software that we offer, if you come to our website on the homepage and you click this software download page, you'll get right to it. There's MacroWorks. Here's basic setup, which only does hardware mode. There's Controller Mate for OS X. And then also, if you want to get to our SDKs, I believe that's under support.
No.
Nope.
Oh, developer right there.
Sorry, why am I not seeing it?
Go down.
Down.
Developer.
Oh, on this page, developer. Yeah, or under software and SDKs. And they're free downloads. Everything's there. That's it. We covered it.
Yeah, I think so. Well, all right, we're going to stick around for some
We'll close this out.
Q&A.
And we'll look for your questions in the chat.
Yep.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye. And we're back.
We're back.
Hello.
So, questions, comments?
So, got one comment here saying, custom integration using the SDK basically means it's going to be plug and play. It's pretty cool. It is very cool.
It is very cool. And, you know, there's so much flexibility in XKeys. One thing I didn't mention was that we can combine these things even in the same box. You can do software mode and you can have hardware macros on separate keys.
Yep.
You can do an integration and you can still have hardware macros on separate keys. Right. And then the approach that these integrators take changes too. In vMix, as you guys know who use it, it's completely customizable. Any key on any XKeys can be set to a function in vMix. An activator can turn the LED indicator on. Really flexible. Wirecast went in a different direction, and they really defined their layout to match their interface. They have some macro keys that are programmable, but for the most part, that board, you plug it in, it works, you hit an input, and it's going to come up.
Yep.
And there's, you know, I can see pluses and minuses to both solutions.
Do you have a favorite, Rudy wants to know? Software or hardware mode?
Do we have a favorite? Well, on my desk, I use both.
Same here.
and I think one of the reasons is that I have some applications that I use that for whatever reason, they don't like that message that's injected into the keyboard and mouse stream.
Yep.
So we use hardware mode so that application cannot ignore the message. So.
Yes, the SDK is free download.
Yep. And we also have a new SDK for OS X as well.
Mm-hmm.
Any more questions? I guess,
we
covered it. You know where to get all of us. Anything else?
Yep. All right. Well, make sure you come back next week, and we're going to dive a little deeper into software.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Bye.